Hello, everyone, and welcome to XPW TV. I'm Joey Styles. Joining me live from London, England, in our new international television studio is the lovely Roxanne Hall. And later on this hour, Roxanne will give us news of the first two British wrestlers recruited by XPW as part of XPW's global expansion. And joining me live from Los Angeles, the one and only Chris Kloss.
Thank you very much, Joey Styles. We got two huge matches tonight on XPW TV. We're going to see the debut of the Shark Boy taking on Chris Chetti, fresh off his victory against Confederate Currency Chris Hamrick, and the XPW World Heavyweight title will be on the line. The franchise, Shane Douglas, is going to be defending against Chris Candido. It was supposed to be against Chris Candido. All sorts of mayhem. We're going to see that in a little bit. Plus, you don't want to miss my exclusive interview. He had a lot to say. I'm talking about Shark Boy. Stay tuned, fans.
Hello! Hi, Shane. TikTok! Oh, yeah, TikTok! I got all the time in the world to inflict pain on you. How's those hands doing, huh? Need some calcium pills? I know, that night after the show, you went to the hospital and you said, please give me some pain medicine, I'm hurting. I told everyone you were the paper champion. You fight old men, you fight has-beens, you fight drug addicts. But you know what? You never fought one that's got a little screw loose, a little mental, a little touched. You see, December 21st, the night of your destruction, you go ahead and call your friends. You go ahead and call the big mothership in the sky for help. You go ahead and call your mama and let her know you ain't coming home that night. Because vicious Vic Grimes has put more people in the hospital than alcoholism itself. And I'm gonna intoxicate your whole body with pain. And you wanna know why? You wanna know why, Shane? Because I can. So go ahead, polish up my belt. And I can't wait to take your ego down.
Bye-bye.
Why can crunch numbers unlike that other dork that used to run that company? Yeah, it's... Mr. Franchise's office!
Good afternoon, Danny Doring, line two.
Did you say Danny Doring, line two?
Yes, line two.
Can you get rid... Come up with a couple of excuses. Tell him I've gone to see my doctor today for my wrist. Get rid of him for me, okay?
Okay, thank you.
What the hell's Danny Doring on with me? Leave me alone.
Chris Chetti, who earned himself a spot on the XPW roster by virtue of his upset victory over the former top contender for the world television title, Chris Hamrick. And Chetti has not stopped talking about it since. You want to know how good Chris Chetti is? Just ask him. He'll be happy to tell you. Thought it was safe to return to South Philadelphia. Making his XPW debut, the one, the only, it's the Shark Boy.
Fans, introducing first
from Amityville, New York, Chris Chetti! And his opponent, from 20,000 leagues under the sea, this is Shark Boy!
Referee Patrick Hernandez to officiate this matchup, and this should be a lot of fun. And the fans already solidly behind Shark Boy. Chris Chetti, a graduate of ECW's House of Hardcore. He was trained by none other than Perry Saturn and Chetty's own first cousin, Taz. Chetti ducks the collar and elbow tie. Very proud of himself is Chris Chetti. Chris Chetti, a very accomplished amateur wrestler himself from the state of New York. And was just starting to gain some momentum in ECW when that company went bankrupt. And the fans all over Chris Chetti. They tie up. Side headlock now by Chetti. Shark Boy looking for a way out. Into a hammerlock. Nice escape. Chetti reaches back. Reversal. Nicely done by Chetti. Shark Boy up and over, lands on his feet behind Chetti. Waist lock. Chetti hangs on. Shark Boy rolls through. Beautiful standing drop kick. Down goes Chris Chetti and rolls to the outside. You may have seen Shark Boy up and down the East Coast, wrestling for small independent groups. He's even made an appearance on pay-per-view for NWA TNA. He's worked overseas as well. This his debut in XPW. I'd have to say that Chetti has the home field advantage in front of these, the hardest fans in the world to please, the South Philadelphia wrestling fans. Chetti now mocking the dorsal finned Shark Boy. Shark Boy's up for the ride, ducks the clothesline, full head of steam now, ducks the elbow. Tilt the world, flying head scissors, nicely done by Shark Boy. Chetti back to his feet, deep arm drag into an arm bar.
He's on my arm! He's on my arm!
Chetti crying that Shark Boy is on his arm. Yes, that's why it's called an arm bar. Shark Boy is biting! Shark Boy is actually biting right through the air hole in the mask. Imagine that. A Shark Boy biting. Who'd have thunk it? Shark Boy backed into the corner. Overhand right misses. The elbow does not. Chetti charges. Backdrop all the way to the floor. Down goes Chetti and hard. Chetti very slow to get back to his feet. Took a hard spill on the concrete. Up and over goes Shark Boy with the pescado. And how appropriate that Shark Boy would use the pescado, which is a fishing reference. Chetti face first now to the steel guardrail. Chetti thrown back in. Shark Boy gives chase, now ascending the turnbuckle. And Chetti shoves the refs into the ropes. Shark Boy gets crunched. Overhand right by Chetti. Knife edge chop. Chetti now going up top. Cinches up Shark Boy. Hits the superplex. Will that be enough? And Chetti choosing to pose and preen for the fans instead of going for the cover. One victory, one upset victory here at XPW. And Chetti thinks he's a superstar who's too good to go for the pinfall attempt. And the fans are now rallying behind Sharkboy. Face first into the top turnbuckle goes Sharkboy. That'll dent your dorsal fin. Chetti sets his head too soon and pays for it. Clothesline duck. Beautiful neck breaker by Chris Chetti, who says that's all. Lateral press, hook of the leg, two, no. Chetti thought that was all. Referee Patrick Hernandez says no. Chetti now wasting time yet again, arguing with the referee. And he pays for it. Beautiful straight right hand. Chetti set for the ride. Chetti hangs on. Arm ring. Leg kick from the shoulder blades. That one missed. But Chetti takes Sharkboy over. Nice lead up. Referee right there is Chetti going for the cross arm breaker. Sharkboy did not give up. And Chetti is upset yet again. Sharkboy's up for the ride. Chetti charges. Close line in the corner. Nowhere for Sharkboy to go. Chetti is just so proud of himself. Again, he fails to follow up. And Chris Chetti is no rookie. He knows better than this. This is just arrogance. Chetti is being blinded by arrogance. Reversal out of the corner. Chetti climbs the ropes, beautiful side kick. And a front kick right to the face. Leaping axe kick. And that should be all. Chetti thinks it is. How kind of cover is that? Two things I can say about Chris Chetti. Number one, he has improved greatly since I last saw him wrestle in calendar year 2000. But his attitude and his arrogance are going to cost him if he continues to underestimate opponents, including and especially Sharkboy. Sharkboy now folded up. Chetti taking his sweet time yet again. Now wasting time jawjacking with the fans. Chetti all the way up top. Launches himself at Sharkboy, but no water in the pool. Get it? Pool? Shark? Ah, never mind. Can Sharkboy capitalize? Referee Patrick Hernandez putting the count on both competitors. The fans are rallying behind Sharkboy. Whoever gets to their feet first will have the decided advantage in this matchup. It's anyone's matchup. It's a pick-up. They're both up. Sharkboy beats Chetti to the punch. And the fans chanting Shark with each and every blow. Chetti gets planted. Beautiful standing drop kick. Neck breaker by Sharkboy. Will that be all? Hooks the leg. Two. No. Left shoulder up. Face first into the turnbuckle. Ladies and gentlemen, I think we have a growing phenomenon on our hands here at XPW in Sharkboy. Tip up in the corner. Belly to back suplex. Sharkboy's going up top. Missile drop kick right to the point of the jaw. Will it be enough? No. Chetti kicks out yet again. You've got to give credit where credit is due. Chetti showing great resilience in this matchup. Chetti puts the brakes on. He's looking for the Amityville Horror. Will he hit it? No. Sharkboy escapes. Hits the front kick. Chetti with the reversal. Sharkboy puts the brakes on. Ducks the clothesline. Chetti takes him over. Beautifully done. Sharkboy gets driven headfirst into the mat. Sit out, board buster, should be all. And Sharkboy kicks out. And the fans are loving it. Chris Chetti just can't seem to figure out a way to put away the shark. Sharkboy's up for the ride. Here comes Chetti. Takes a boot to the face. Sharkboy hooks Chetti. And Chetti gets blasted! Cover! Sharkboy gets the
new your winner, Sharkboy!
Sharkboy victorious in his XPW debut, and in the process caps the ace. These extreme Philly fans. The arrogant Chris Chetti finds himself as shark bait.
Sharkboy, a very mysterious figure. We finally got you for an interview here on XPW TV. An impressive debut you had against Chris Chetti, and a victory as well. How do you feel about that? How do you? How do you feel about it? What? A great win over Chris Chetti in your XPW debut. Sharkboy, how do you feel?
So Sharkboy is victorious in his XPW debut and in the process has captured the hearts of these extreme wrestling fans in Philadelphia. As for Chris Chetti, his own arrogance cost him that matchup, and maybe curbing his arrogance is a lesson he did not learn from his mentor, his trainer, and his first cousin, WWE superstar Taz. Fans, don't go away. When we come back, the XPW World Heavyweight title is on the line. The franchise, Shane Douglas, gives his former tag team partner and triple threat member, Chris Candido, one final shot at the 16 pounds of gold. It's do or die for Candido. Don't go away.
Okay, J-Lo, I know you've done Attack of the 50-Foot Woman, The Killer Tomatoes, but that's all B-movie. All right, we are mainstream. XPW. That's where it's all at. XPW. We are nationwide. We're in every state. We're even in Europe. Okay? I'm gonna make you a star. You need to be here with XPW. If you wanna make it to the top, Lizzie Borden's gonna bring you all the way, baby, all the way. I can manage you all the way to the top and beyond. All the bling bling you want.
Lizzie!
Honey,
let's go. Yeah. Listen, we got a phone call. We know where he is. Oh. Sorry, honey, got no time to meet you. We know where he is. Let's go.
All right. Jill, I'll call you later. Rude.
So the franchise Shane Douglas wanted to give Chris Candido one final shot at the XPW World title. He wanted to prove once and for all that he was the glue that held the triple threat together in the first place. And of course, if Candido won the match, he would be the XPW World Heavyweight Champion. However, if Candido lost the match, he would never receive a shot at the XPW World title for life. Douglas, Candido, went into this match knowing the stipulations. However, neither one had any idea what was about to transpire.
here comes the XPW World Heavyweight Champion, my new boss, the franchise Shane Douglas. Money behind the man. Is he boy?
For a reason. The line goes like this, Hunter. Why? Because I am a champion. Why? Because I built this building. Why? Because I'm just that damn good. Now, Joey Styles, zoom in here, Mr. Cameraman. You decide you try to make me the boss of the company in a franchise. Look like an ass in front of all these jerkwads in Philadelphia.
Oh, I didn't try, boss. I did.
I'll deal with you later, little man, but you are stocked with me as a world heavyweight champion.
Maybe not for long, mouth.
Now. So do I. Maybe next month I make fish bait out of that shit. But tonight, you people will watch the greatest world heavyweight champion of all time as I regain the form that takes this business back to the top. Do you like necrophilia? Do you like somebody humping a damned mannequin? Do you like Vince McMahon? Then XPW is for you, and like it or not, I am the franchise of X.
Well, he may be the franchise, but he may not be the world heavyweight champion when this match is over with. Because Chris Candido gets just one more shot at Shane Douglas's World Heavyweight title. And nobody knows the franchise any better than his former Triple Threat Tag Team partner, Chris Candido. Here he comes, led to the ring by Tammy Sitton. Wait a...
That's vicious Vic Grimes. Grimes is attacking Chris Candido. Grimes just attacked Chris Candido.
Get the hell away from me.
It makes me sick to my stomach that I have to watch this crap. That you, idiot, drug addict, stupid, pillhead gets title shots week in and week out.
And you, Shane Douglas. Do you work for the old folks home or something? You give them all the matches. You got 80-year-old people walking around here on crutches. If I suck, you swallow, so shut the hell up. Hey, little paper champion. Get the You want to dance with the vicious one? Huh? You can't go running like you do in every damn promotion that you are when the heat gets turned up. Oh, no. What do you say? You want to dance with the vicious one? You want to dance? Put that damn title on the line.
Grimes going after the leg of Chris Candido yet again.
Hey, fat ass! You come out here, accuse me of ducking you. I fight the toughest competition walking this planet today.
Not me. You've been running.
Okay, Candido's unable to go. You won a world title match. Does he get a world title match? Does he get a world title match? Does he get a world title match? Oh, and bring it to the franchise, because you son of a bitch, tonight you get your ass franchise.
Well, Vic Grimes gets his wish. He has injured Chris Candido. Candido is in no physical condition to challenge the franchise for the World Heavyweight title. So Vic Grimes now finds himself with the opportunity of his career to take the XPW World Heavyweight title away from the one, the only, the franchise Shane Douglas. Grimes ducks the clothesline, ducks the elbow. Clothesline and down goes the World Heavyweight champion. Douglas in trouble early on. Grimes is younger, bigger, and stronger than the franchise.
Come on, franchise! Get up!
Grimes hammering the champion in the corner. Stupid a slam on the World Heavyweight Champion as Grimes just muscles him over and drops the leg down across the face of the franchise.
This is your champion! This is a piece of
shit! Grimes showing no respect whatsoever towards the franchise. Shane Douglas now picking up the champion and muscling him down to the canvas. Lizzie Borden can only look on as her meal ticket, her man, is getting beaten down by the challenger, Vicious Vic Grimes. Shane Douglas being worked over in the corner. Gotta wonder how long Grimes has had this plan, the franchise Shane Douglas plan for Chris Candido, a man he knows very well, his former partner. He did not train. He did not prepare. He did not study tapes of vicious Vic Grimes and the champions at a severe disadvantage. Even with the equalizer, Lizzie Borden at ringside, the title is in jeopardy here tonight in South Philadelphia. Douglas set for the ride yet again. Here comes Grimes, clothesline in the corner, nowhere for the franchise to go. And Grimes trying to cave in the skull of Shane Douglas. Grimes with a headbutt to the groin of the champion, and it couldn't have happened to a nicer guy. Now Grimes has the rubber chicken. The franchise hammering back, but a chop to the throat opens up the gullet, and Grimes shoves the chicken down the throat of the franchise, Shane Douglas. Douglas being choked by chicken. That's a first. The franchise step for the ride. Grimes charges and misses and tumbles all the way to the floor. Grimes with the reversal on the outside. Douglas hits the steal. Grimes charges. Douglas sidesteps the challenger. And Grimes up and over the steel guard rail onto the floor. Shane Douglas may have bought himself some time. Where the hell is he going? What the hell is Shane Douglas doing on the top turnbuckle? Is he oh my God! Shane Douglas goes airborne to the concrete! The champion now in control of this matchup after risking his own career diving under the concrete. Step suplex on the floor. Douglas now ripping away at the face of Vic Grimes. Douglas throws Grimes over the steel guardrail back towards the ringside area. Reversal. Shane Douglas hits the steel ring post. Steel chair across the skull of the champion. And Douglas, I don't think he realized he just rolled back into the ring where he can be pinned, where he can lose the World Heavyweight title. Vic Grimes setting up that steel chair. That does not bode well for the World Heavyweight Champion. It does not bode well for Shane Douglas. Douglas looks semi-conscious at best. His
more of Vic Grimes than I need to see. Douglas slowly rising to his feet. Shane catches the boot, spins Grimes around, hooks him, and Shane Douglas just landed on that steel chair. Did you hear his hand crunch? Shane Douglas was looking to suplex Vic Grimes on that steel chair, but the chair collapsed. Unbeknown to Douglas, and Douglas, with the full weight of Vic Grimes in himself, had his hand crunched on that steel chair. This is the greatest opportunity Vic Grimes has ever had in his entire career. Now is Vic Grimes' time. Tonight is his night. The franchise Shane Douglas, already wrestling with a broken thumb, seems to have injured his other hand, his left hand. And if Vic Grimes can put away the franchise right here, right now, he will have made history. He will be the new XPW World Heavyweight Champion. And it looks like Grimes isn't looking to just defeat the franchise, to beat the franchise. Vicious Vic Grimes with that sick look on his face. Lizzie Borden trying to stop Grimes, who's got that length of guardrail. And Lizzie Borden is crushed between the guardrails. Now setting up that guardrail on the outside. Douglas now shoulder first into that steel ring post. Back on her feet, just barely. And Grimes is hoisting that length of guardrail into the ring itself. The franchise Shane Douglas is in dire straits. As the near 400-pound Vic Grimes goes up top and hits the splash on Douglas. Two, no, Douglas somehow gets the shoulder up. Shane Douglas, a broken thumb on his right hand, who obviously just broke his left hand, still manages to kick out. He's still thinking about the World Heavyweight Championship. And here comes Chris Candido. Candido now, who can barely walk, takes Grimes off the top turnbuckle. Candido limping, drops the leg on Vic Grimes. You can see the groin and the quadricep. The right leg of Chris Candido is all bruised. It's black and blue. Diving headbutt misses. Scooping a slam on Candido. Now Grimes focuses on that guardrail yet again. Oh. Grimes sets up the guardrail in the corner. Candido going after Douglas, going after Grimes. Candido launched face first into that unforgiving steel. And there goes Douglas as well. What strength by Grimes! Douglas press slammed into the steel guardrail. Vicious Vic Grimes is decimating both former Triple Threat members. Grimes thrown to the outside. Candido throwing caution to the wind, launches himself at Vic Grimes. That hand of Douglas is swelling up already. Originally, it was supposed to be the franchise Shane Douglas defending against Chris Candido. It turned into Vic Grimes eliminating Candido. So Grimes challenging Shane Douglas. And now we've got a three-way dance for the XPW World Heavyweight title. The champion, the franchise Shane Douglas. Both challengers, Chris Candido and vicious Vic Grimes, smell weakness. They know the franchise is injured. One of those two men will leave Philadelphia tonight as the XPW World Heavyweight Champion if they can capitalize on the injured hands of the franchise Shane Douglas. They'll never get him over. The hell they won't! And Candido suckers the franchise in. And now Tammy has thrown Lizzie in the ring. Well, I haven't said this in a while. Here it comes. In comes Grimes. Douglas now using that cast as a weapon out of desperation. Grimes set for the ride, puts the brakes on, DDTs Douglas and Candido. Double clothesline. Lizzie and Tammy now slapping and punching away at Grimes. And down they go. DDT on the women. Candido back to his feet. He gets thrown to the outside by Grimes. Grimes has Lizzie Borden. Oh no. The franchise tries to save Lizzie. He gets caught right in the face. the hell is this madman doing? Oh my God, no! No! And the tables didn't even break. Lizzie Borden absorbed the full force of that. Oh my God! Douglas rolls up Candido. Shane Douglas has somehow escaped with the World Heavyweight Championship.
The winner of the match, and still, XPW.
How did he do that?
World champion.
And he's leaving Lizzie.
The franchise.
Grimes can't believe it.
Shane Douglas.
Grimes did not get pinned by the World Heavyweight Champion. He broke both of Shane Douglas's hands in that matchup, and Vic Grimes has now cemented his status as the new number one contender for the XPW World Heavyweight Championship. He has already challenged the franchise Shane Douglas to a one-on-one matchup for the gold on Saturday night, December 21st at the XPW Arena, at an event we're calling Merry Effin' Xmas. Vicious Vic Grimes' ascension into number one contender status has pretty much created a buzz among the wrestling media across the Atlantic in the UK. Speaking of which, right now we go live to London and Roxanne Hall.
As I promised you last week, XPW has signed two of England's finest wrestlers, Johnny Storm and the Zebra Kid. They will be making their XPW debut Saturday, December 21st at Merry Effin' Xmas. Chris, Joey, back to you.
God save the Queen! The fascist regime!
So there you have it, two of the UK's hottest young talents to become exclusive to XPW starting calendar year 2003. But fans here in the States can get a sneak preview at these two live in action Saturday night, December 21st at the XPW Arena in South Philadelphia, Pennsylvania. It's Merry Effin' Xmas. And on that night, Vic Grimes will challenge the franchise Shane Douglas for the XPW World Heavyweight Championship. And right here next week on XPW TV, both the XPW World Tag Team titles and the King of the Deathmatch titles will be on the line. For Roxanne Hall in London and Chris Kloss in LA, I'm Joey Styles from New York City saying we'll see you next week.
Vic, wait, I want to talk to you.
What the hell do you want?
I know I deserve it, but hear me out. I know a champion when I see one, and,
what?
Well, after December 21st, I want to, you know, manage the champion.
Get out of here!
Hit him! Hit him harder! Harder! Yeah. Come on!
You want to be champion, huh? Here's a taste in the mouth!
World champion!
This is it, baby! This is what it is to be a champion!
Oh, how does that feel, little man?
Back over, son of a bitch.
Back over.
You want to be champion,
come on,
huh?
Run him over again.
Sirens.
Get her. Come on with me.
He's done.
You're
champion,
so done.
Huh?
You're